Welcome back, aliens. My name is Navin Reddy, and let's continue with this series on JavaScript. Now, in this video, we'll talk about arithmetic operators. Now, see, when you talk about a language or you talk about surface, you perform some operations, right? Now, it can be calculations, it can be logical operations, but here, let's focus on calculations. And we do that a lot on computers as well, right? So let's say if you want to add two numbers, you want to subtract two numbers, you want to find a division of a number, you can do that. And for it, you need to use certain operators. And the thing is, in the earlier videos, we have talked about most of them. But still, you know, just to complete that topic, let's talk about. In fact, once we reach to the end of the video, we'll talk about some important operators and some tricky parts. So let's get started. So what I will do is I will create a variable here, num, and initially the value of number will be, let's say, 1. And I want to perform some addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, just to show you that. So what I will do here is I will take another number here, which is result, and with this number, I will perform that operation. Or maybe just to make it more effective, like let's take some other number so that we can perform all the required operations, let's say 4 and 2. And we know because what happens when you use these simple numbers, easy to calculate, at least in our mind. So what I will do is I will say num1 plus num2, and we know it, right? This is addition operator. So we'll print it and we'll print result. Okay, this is the addition of two numbers. And then we'll print, let's run this code and let's see what happens. So if you run this code, you got 6. That is good. And now I want to find the subtraction. It's very simple. So just we are trying to complete that as soon as possible because it's very simple. In fact, in the earlier video, we also talked about what happens when you have different types of data and when you apply these operators. But as of now, just to keep it simple, we are going for numbers, right? We can actually also perform the division operator. When you say divide, you can say we got 2. In fact, you can also divide a number by 0, which will give you infinity. You can also divide a number by a string, it will give you NaN. You can try those things, right? But then we know what is addition, subtraction, division. Can you multiply? Yes, with the help of this asterisk symbol. And if you run this code, we got 8. So basic operation is very easy, right? What about if you want to find a remainder? So in this case, we'll use a percentage operator. So let's try and we should get 0, right? So 4 divided by 2 and the remainder is 0. So we can try with other numbers as well. Let's say if you have a number as 5 and then if you find a remainder by doing that with 2, you will get 1. Okay, this is working. So no issues with this thing, right? And then if you have two strings, I mean, string and a string, it will give you concatenation, right? But what happens, example, let's say the num1 is not actually a number, but it's a boolean value true. And num2 is also true. And the operation you want to perform here is addition. Now what will happen? Pause this video, go to comment section and type the answer. What do you think? What is the answer here? Now logically, it can be true because if you know the concept of complex logical operations, so when you have two trues, it might be something like that, or it might be NaN because you can't add boolean values. Let's try what happens. I hope you have answered that in the comment section. We got 2. Why? Why we got 2 here? That's weird. See, it's actually very simple. Remember when we talked about truthy value and falsy values? Whenever you have a true, and if you try to convert that, because we are using a plus operator here, right? Now, type conversion, it says, okay, when you have a plus operator, and on both sides you have boolean values, let me convert them for you. So this number will be converted into numbers. And the first number, so 0 is false, so 1 is true. And that's why we got 2, right? So 1 plus 1 is 2. Very simple. Okay, this works. Now what I want to do is, let me just remove result for time being and let me also remove num2. Let's only focus on num1 here. And when you have only one num, let's go with num. And here, let me print num. Okay, so let's go with number 4 again. And let me run this code and you can see we got 4. Let me just clear the screen. Now what I will do is I will just add this number by itself. So what I'm going to do is I will say num is equal to num plus 2. So what I'm doing is I'm taking that number 4, I'm adding 2. So this makes sense, right? So it should give you 6 because here what we are doing is we are taking the value of num, which is 4. 4 plus 2 is 6, then it will assign. That's how it goes. So first it will try to solve this expression. Okay, this is expression. What is expression? Whenever you have something which will be getting resolved to a value, it is expression. Example, num plus 2 is expression, 5 plus 2 is expression, high is an expression, 5 is an expression, because I can assign 5 to a number. So here we are saying num plus 2 is an expression which will be assigned to num, which is 6 in this case, and you got the answer. Now when you want to add a number by itself, example, we are adding num by 2, right? So we can use a shorthand. So instead of using this syntax, let me just comment this here. So we can use double slash to comment a code, and then we can use shortcut. So we can say, we want to add num itself, right? So we can say num plus. So we want to add num itself with 2. Okay, this is called shorthand operators. So instead of using this syntax, we can use this. So we are saying we want to add num by itself plus 2. Let's try, and it worked, right? It worked. So we can also do that with a number 1. So let's say if you want to do this operation, which is num equal to num plus 1. In this case, we can say num plus equal to 1. So this should also work. We should get 5. But specifically, when you have only 1, you can actually use a special operator which is called num plus plus. Plus plus operator. So it also means increment. So if num is 5, it will give you 6. If num is 6, it will give you 7. So num plus plus is an increment. And that's why, if you know, there's a language called C and C++. C was the initial version. C++ is a next increment of C, right? So that's why they went with C++ name. Oh, we have not seen the output yet. It still works, right? So instead of using num equal to num plus 1, we can say num plus plus. Okay, so this is how you can increment. What about if you want to do this? Num equal to num minus 1. Any guess? You guessed it right. We can use num minus minus, right? And this works. So plus plus will increment, minus minus will decrement. In fact, the fun part is you can actually use plus plus at the start. So you can either say num plus plus or you can say plus plus num. Both will give you the same answer in this case. Okay, why I said in this case? Actually, the thing is they both have different names. This syntax which we are using here is called pre-increment. And when you say num plus plus, this is called post-increment. In fact, there should be a separate video talking about these things, but let's try to do that here itself. So we got num plus plus and we got plus plus num. One is pre-increment and one is post-increment. What's the difference? See, in both this case, example, even if you try this syntax or this syntax, it will ultimately give you the next iteration, right? So what I'm doing is I will run this code. What is your guess? What will be the output? It should be 6, right? Because here we are saying plus plus num, which will make this number 4 to 5. So this is 5 here. And at this point, we are saying num plus plus, it will make it 6. So if I run this code, we got 6. So this is working, right? But we still don't know the difference between pre-increment and post-increment. Let me do that. Oh, before going ahead, what if you have minus minus num and num minus minus? What it will be called? Pre-decrement, post-decrement. Right, so the name changes. But just to understand the difference between these two, let's go with this example here. So what I will do now is let me create another variable, which is x equal to, and I will say x equal to num plus plus. Okay, so now what we are doing is we are incrementing num, that makes sense, and then we are assigning the value to x. So this is an expression which will give you a value, and that value we are assigning to x. And then let me print x here. Actually, let me print both. Let me print x and then let me also print num. And let's see what's the difference between these two numbers. So what do you think? Even before running this code, what is your guess? And please also mention the timeline, okay? Because the problem is in this video, I have asked you for so many questions to answer that in the comment section. So what you can do is for different answers, you can give a timeline. At this point, this is the answer so that it will be helpful for others to actually know what you're thinking. So what happens when you are learning something new, and then if everyone is getting the right answer, you're getting the wrong answer, you feel bad. But what if everyone is getting the wrong answer and you're getting the right answer? You feel good. What if everyone is getting the wrong answer? You feel way better because not everyone knows about it, right? So it's a good feeling. Okay, so come back. So here we are doing that, and let me see what happens. Before that, I will clear the screen and run. And you can see we got 4 and 5. So we got here 4. Oh, that's weird. Why we got 4? See, num 5 makes sense because we are incrementing it. Why we got 4 here? It's because this num plus plus is called post increment. Now, what this post increment means? So post increment just means that it will first fetch the value, then it will assign the value. So basically, we have two operations here, increment and assignment. So we are assigning the value to x, right? And then we are also incrementing it. Which will happen first? Since this is post increment, it will first assign the value, then it will increment. So before increment, what's the value of num? It's 4. So 4 will be assigned to x and then it will increment. Okay. And that's why we got 4 for x and 5 for num. What will happen when you do this? Now, this time we are not doing post increment, we are doing pre increment. Now you should be able to guess it, right? It should be 5 and 5. Now, why 5, 5 is because we are first incrementing it. Pre-increment, right? Pre. So it is first incrementing it, making it the value of 5, and then assigning to x, which is 5 in this case. So that's the difference between pre-increment and post-increment. Okay, so before ending the video, we have something more. Let's say I have this number 4, and I want to find a cube of this number. How do you find a cube of a number? It's very simple. Let me say let result equal to. You can say num into num into num. So that's how you can find cube of a number, right? The other way you can do is, let me just run this code first. Let me just print the value in the console and let's see what happens. You can see we got 64. But what if I want to do something else? So we got a math class, math interface. Like, of course, we'll talk about class interface later. But as of now, we got something inbuilt. So let's say, imagine we have inbuilt function called math.pow. And in this, you can pass two parameters, 4, 3. Now, what is 4? The actual value. And then 3 is cube. Or if you want to find a square, you will say 2. So this is actually a power. So when you say 3, you are finding 4 raised to 3, which is 4^3. And that's why it's a power. Right, so if you go over it, it will say it's a function or a method returns a value of a base expression. X is the base value and Y is the exponent value. Right, so this you can use this and it will give the same answer. Right, but then in new version, which is ES6, we got something new, and that is using double star or double asterisks. So when you use single asterisk, it is multiplication. Double asterisk means power, and you can see we got the same answer. If you want to find a square, you can do that. If you want to find 4^4, you can do that. So that's with the help of the asterisk symbol, double asterisk symbol. So that's it from this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me in the comment section and do subscribe for further videos. Bye-bye.